Moderna vaccine to enter Phase 3 trial, but how does it work? Moderna's vaccine is set to enter Phase 3 clinical trial. A total of 30,000 participants are expected throughout the trial period. The upcoming trial will focus on the vaccine's efficacy against SARS-CoV-2. Dr. Barney Graham, Deputy Director of the Vaccine Research Center at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, explained the technology behind the vaccine. The vaccine specifically uses mRNA to allow human cells to recognize SARS-CoV-2. DNA makes up the human genome, but the body needs RNA to create various proteins. Cells use transcription to produce RNA templates from DNA templates, which are composed of nucleotides. Using the same technique, the RNA of the SARS-CoV-2 virus could be delivered into the body as a vaccine. If the RNA was injected into a muscle cell, the RNA would enter the cell's body, not its nucleus. Ribosomes would translate that RNA to create a related protein. The experimental vaccine used mRNA to be translated into a protein. That protein would be seated on the muscle cell, yet it would appear seated on a virus. The appearance would alert the immune system of a foreign matter. Because of the virus-like features, dedicated white blood cells would create the correct antibodies. The antibodies should match the various surfaces of the protein. This is what the vaccine intends to do in real life. Instead of giving the whole virus, the vaccine only exposes the person to a part of the pathogen. And when SARS-CoV-2 attacks, the body is already equipped with antibodies. According to CNN, SARS-CoV-2 features 30,000 nucleotides in its genome, while the vaccine only features 3,700 to 4,000 nucleotides. This is the result of codon optimization, wherein nucleotides are sequenced to give the viral protein. Results from Phase 1 trials showed that antibody activity was apparent in the first and second vaccination. However, the second vaccination had greater detectable levels of antibodies and higher risk of side effects. Participants who received a second shot at a higher dose were more likely to develop side effects. Dr. Graham said that between three vaccine doses, the 100 microgram dose seemed a balanced dose. It was well tolerated and induced excellent antibody activity. If the vaccine is 70 to 80% effective, it may start herd immunity. The Phase 1 trial results were published in the New England Journal of Medicine.